In this illustration, we'll analyze a ball coming back to the projection point. Here we are given that a ball is projected with a velocity u at an elevation from a point distance d from a smooth vertical wall in a plane perpendicular to it. Now it is saying after rebounding from the wall, it returns to the point of projection. It is saying if E is the coefficient of restitution between ball and wall, we are required to find the maximum distance d for which ball will come back to the projection point. Here in solution we can see the situation is like this. There is a wall and from a distance d from the wall, there is a point from which a ball is projected with a speed u at an angle alpha. And we are given that after collision with the wall, it rebounds and it lands back to the same point of projection like this. Here we can see if t equals to 0, ball is projected, and say at time t1, ball hits the wall, then here we can write if ball hits the wall after time t1, this implies we use t1 as equals to d by u cos alpha because the ball would be moving with the horizontal speed u cos alpha. And if the ball strikes the wall at a speed u cos alpha, it will rebound with the normal velocity e u cos alpha if e is the coefficient of restitution. And we can write if ball takes a time t2 in reaching back from wall to projection point, then here we can write the value of t2 would be equals to d by EU cos alpha. And the total time in which ball is coming back is the vertical time of flight because as the vertical velocity of ball is u sin alpha and as the wall is smooth, the ball strikes with u sin alpha and after collision also it moves up with u sin alpha, reaches a maximum height and then comes back. So here we can write the total time of flight. Here we can write as t1 plus t2, which is d by u cos alpha plus d by eu cos alpha is equals to the time of flight we can write as 2u sin alpha by g because total time of flight remains same. So on simplifying this relation, we can get the value of d is equals to, this can be written as e times u square, this sin alpha cos alpha we can write as sin 2 alpha divided by g multiplied by 1 plus e. So in the situation of this, the value of d, we are required to find the maximum distance d for which this will take place. So here we can write here d is a maximum when sin 2 alpha is equals to 1, which happens when alpha is equals to 45 degree, and which gives us the maximum value of d that is equals to e u square divided by g multiplied by 1 plus e. That is the final result of this problem.